Yo, 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 yo! So, welcome back again guys for another video in hydraulics. So, pag-uusapan natin ngayon yung part 2 nung video natin for weirs. So, ulitin ko lang that a weir is a flow measuring device. So it is also used to control flow in an open channel. So, gaya na na-discuss natin dun sa ating previous video or dun sa part 1 ng video natin for weirs, meron tayong tinatawag na rectangular contracted weir. So, sinasabi lang na yung width ng open channel is not equal to the weir length. So, yung weir length na tinutukoy natin dito is yung width ng opening ng weir. So, gaya nga na nabanggit natin dun sa first video, meron tayong dalawang klase ng rectangular contracted weir. So, yun ay weir with two end contraction and a weir with one end contraction. So, kung titingnan natin dun sa figure, yung weir with two end contraction, yung structure ng weir on both ends is extended on the upper part of the open channel. So, yung sa one end contraction naman, isang side lang ng weir structure yung extended hanggang dun sa upper part ng open channel. So, kung titingnan natin sa figure, yung nangyari dun sa overflowing water dun sa weir ay liliit o magko-contract yung width ng overflowing water compared dun sa weir length. Kasi ang assumption natin, kapag ka-suppress yung weir, yung width ng overflowing water is also equivalent to the weir length. At since makokompress nga or magko-contract yung width ng overflowing water, kailangan natin computein yung contracted weir length. So, i-denote natin yung contracted weir length as L sub C. So, in general formula for that would be L sub C is equal to L or yung weir length minus 0.1 times uppercase N times uppercase H. So, ano ba dito yung uppercase N? So, yung N, yung number of end contraction. Siyempre, kapag 2 end contraction yung type ng weir, so ang N natin is equivalent to 2. Kapag 1 end contraction naman, N is equal to 1. At once na makompute natin ito, ito na yung gagamitin natin para dun sa formula on computing the discharge or the flow rate in a rectangular weir. So, na-derive na natin yan from the previous video. So, take note lang ha, na magkaiba yung L sub C sa L. So, yung L sub C is the contracted weir length and L is the original weir length. And syempre, yung uppercase H is the overflow head. So, ngayon naman ay pumunta na tayo dun sa derivation para sa triangular weir o a V-notch weir. So, ngayon ay gumawa muna tayo ng simpleng illustration para dun sa gagawin nating derivation. So, gumawa tayo ng triangular weir. So, syempre, since triangular yan, triangle yung shape ng opening ng weir. So, yung angle ng opening wherein ang opposite ng angle is yung liquid surface. So, ang tawag natin sa angle na to is a vertex angle and we denote it as theta. So, take note lang ha na yung triangular weir is a symmetrical weir. Wherein, kung mag-indicate tayo ng vertical line dun sa vertex angle, ay equal lang din yung mga dimensions on both sides of the triangular weir. So, i-denote naman natin yung width referring on the liquid surface on the top as L. Take note lang na hindi ito yung weir length. So, applicable lang si weir length dun sa rectangular weir. Yung value kasi ng L ay nagbabago depende dun sa height ng leak overflowing on the weir. And we denote that height as uppercase H. So, yun din. Same lang din dun sa rectangular weir. Ang tawag din natin dyan ay head. At since yung makocompute natin na flow rate ay depende dun sa height, ay may co-consider pa rin tayo dito na change in height. So, we take a rectangular strip again and we denote the change in height on that rectangular strip as dh. So, yung h natin dito sa change in height is a lowercase h kasi iba yung magiging value natin for the maximum height which is uppercase h. At ganun pa rin, yung varying height natin o yung magiging variable natin is lowercase h. So, yun yung distance mula dun sa liquid surface hanggang dun sa rectangular strip. So, yung difference nung uppercase h at yung lowercase h is i-denote na natin as uppercase h minus lowercase h. So, wala na tayong nilagay na any other variable. So, ano nga yung dapat natin ma-determine dito is yung discharge o yung flow rate nung overflowing liquid sa weir. So, ganun pa rin ang gagamitin nating working equation. Yung fundamental equation, which is Q sub T o the theoretical discharge or theoretical flow rate equals uppercase A or the area of the opening times V sub T or theoretical velocity. At since varying nga ang value ng Q depending on the cross-sectional area of the opening. Ito ay dahil nakadepende ang value ng flow rate dun sa height ng head ng overflowing liquid. And with that said, ang magiging working equation is dQ sub T equals dA times V sub T. And by using the principles in orifice, V sub T is equal to the square root of 2G times uppercase H. So ulitin ko lang na yung value ng uppercase H depends on the existing head in the system. So in this case, ay ineglect muna natin yung velocity of approach, no? So kung ineneglect natin si velocity of approach, ang value ng uppercase H is the variable height, which is lowercase h. So yung magiging value ng V sub T is the square root of 2G times lowercase h. So, breakdown pa natin yung working equation. So, meron na tayong value ng V sub T. So, ang sunod naman, ano yung value ng dA? So, take natin yung area ng rectangular strip. So, yung area ng rectangle is length times width or x times y. So, in this case, meron na tayong y which is represented by dH. So, ngayon, wala pa tayong length ng rectangle, no? Kaya lang mag-set tayo ng variable para dun sa length ng rectangular strip as x. So, yung maging area na is dA is equal to x times dh. At i-substitute na natin yung values dun sa ating working equation. So that's dq sub t is equal to the quantity of x dh times the quantity of the square root of 2g times lowercase h. So ngayon, kung papansin nyo, ang dapat maging variable lang natin dito is yung lowercase h. So, in this case, sa equation, meron pa tayong unknown x o variable x. So, para mag-get rid natin to, eh, pwede nating i-convert yung value ng x in terms of the existing dimensions na given dun sa ating illustration. And with this case, we need to determine x. So, in determining x, we use ratio and proportion. Kasi kung titingnan natin, if we take the ratio between the width of the liquid surface as denoted by L over uppercase H. So, it is also equivalent to X over uppercase H minus lowercase H. So, if we compute the value of X in terms of the given constants on the scenario, that would be X is equal to L times uppercase H minus lowercase H all over uppercase H. So, upon substitution, that would become dq sub t is equal to the quantity. So, substitute na natin yung x na na-compute natin. So, that's L times the quantity of uppercase H minus lowercase H over uppercase H times the quantity of square root of 2g times lowercase h times dh. At since kailangan nga natin get rid dito, yung derivative functions ay kailangan natin munang ihiwalay yung mga constants. So, yun yung L, uppercase H, and the square root of 2G. So, para dun sa the quantity of uppercase H minus lowercase H, hindi natin siya mapapaghiwalay, no? Kasi iisang expression to. At once na masort na natin, lahat ng constants and variables, the equation would become dQ sub T is equal to the quantity of L over uppercase H times the square root of 2G times the quantity of uppercase H minus lowercase h times the quantity of h raised to 1/2 or square root of h times dh. So, pwede pa natin i-distribute yung function na h raised to 1/2. So, yung magiging equation is dq sub t is equal to the quantity of L over uppercase h times the square root of 2g times the quantity of uppercase h times lowercase h raised to 1/2 minus. So, syempre, ito ay h times h raised to 1/2. So, mangyayari, yung exponents dito, since multiplication to, ay pag-a-add natin. So, yun ay 1 plus 1/2. So, ang result nun ay 3/2. So, yung maging function na would be h raised to 3 halves times dh. So, pwede na natin i-integrate yung mga derivative functions dito. So, puro may power yung mga variable ay gamitin natin yung formula na the integral of u to the n du is equal to 1 over n plus 1 times u raised to n plus 1 plus c. So, yung magiging limits of integration natin dito is from 0 to uppercase h o yung maximum height nung overflowing head dun sa triangular weir. So, perform na natin yung integration. So, yung magiging result would be q sub t is equal to the quantity of L over uppercase H times the square root of 2G times the quantity of H. So, since constant naman yung uppercase H natin dito, ay yung lowercase h lang yung integrate natin. So, that's 1 over 1 half plus 1 times lowercase h raised to 1 half plus 1 minus 1 over 3 halves plus 1 times lowercase h raised to 3 halves plus 1. So, that is bounded from 0 to uppercase h. So, minimize pa natin yung mga values ng constants dito. So, yung denominator na 1 half plus 1 is equivalent to 3 halves. So, since yun ay denominator, yun ay magre-reciprocate at magiging 2 thirds. So, yung exponent naman na 1 half plus 1 is also equivalent to 3 halves. So, ngayon, ito namang denominator na 3 halves plus 1 is equivalent to 5 halves. At since denominator yung 5 halves, magre-reciprocate yun at magiging 2 over 5. At syempre, yung exponent na 3 halves plus 1 is equivalent to 5 halves. So, yung simplified equation dito is the quantity of L over uppercase H times the square root of 2G times the quantity of 2 thirds uppercase H times lowercase h raised to 3 halves minus 2 over 5 times lowercase h raised to 5 halves. And it is bounded from 0 to uppercase h. So, substitute na natin yung limits of integration. So, pag sinubstitute natin yun, yung equation ay magiging the quantity of L over uppercase h times the square root of 2g times the quantity of 2 thirds times uppercase h times yung maximum, no, which is uppercase h raised to 3 halves minus 2 over 5 times, so substitute ulit natin sa lowercase h yung maximum value, so that's uppercase h raised to 5 halves minus, so kapag sinubstitute na natin yung ating lower limit, so that's 0, no, so since both nung expressions is merong h, ay magiging 0 na ito. So, kung titingnan natin, ay common dito yung function na uppercase h. So, para dun sa unang expression na merong uppercase h na function, so, yun ay uppercase h times uppercase h raised to 3 halves. So, gagawin natin dito, add lang natin yung mga exponent. So, 1 plus 3 halves, so that's 5 halves. At pag naging 5 halves na, yung exponent ng first expression na merong function na h, so pwede na nating i-add yung 2 thirds na h raised to 5 halves minus 2 fifths raised to 5 halves kasi magkaparehas na sila ng exponent. So, mangyayari, pag maminusin natin, yung 2 thirds minus 2 fifths. So, 2 thirds minus 2 fifths is also equivalent to 10 minus 6 over, so yung magiging common denominator dito would be 15. So, yung magiging value ng constant is 4 over 15. At since meron denominator dito sa equation na uppercase h, pwede nating i-multiply yun o yung 1 over h dun sa function na h raised to 5 halves. So, ang gagawin naman natin ay pagmaminusin na natin yung mga exponents since division na yung operation. So, that would be 5 halves minus 1. So, ang magiging result nun is 3 halves. So, yung magiging resulting equation na would be q sub t is equal to 4 over 15 times the square root of 2g times l times uppercase h raised to 3 halves. So take note lang na yung value ng L ay nagbavary, no, depende dun sa magiging value ng uppercase H. So sa ganitong banda, kailangan nating i-convert yung value ng L in terms of H. So rewrite lang natin yung na-derive natin na equation. So that's Q sub T is equal to 4 over 15 times the square root of 2G times L times uppercase H raised to 3 halves. At ngayon, gaya nga na nabanggit, kailangan natin i-convert yung value ng L in terms of H. Ngayon, pwede natin makompute yung value ng L in terms of H at kunin natin siya sa right triangle. So para makapag-form tayo ng right triangle, ay i-take natin yung axis of symmetry dun sa vertex point nung opening. So pag tinig natin yung axis of symmetry, so take natin is the vertical axis of symmetry. So mahati yung L, no? Wala namang mangyayari dun sa H. Pero mahati din yung angle. So yung mahating L would be L over 2 at yung mahating vertex angle would be theta over 2. So dahil dito nakapag-create tayo ng right triangle. At ito na yung gagamitin natin para ma-convert natin yung L in terms of uppercase H. So what is the value of L? So we take the ratio between L over 2 over uppercase H. So since yung L over 2 is the opposite of the vertex angle and H is the adjacent, so opposite over adjacent, so that's tangent of theta over 2. So yung value ng L is equivalent to 2 times uppercase H times tangent theta over 2. So substitute na natin yung value ng L dun sa working equation natin. So the resulting equation would be Q sub T is equal to 4 over 15 times the square root of 2G times the quantity. So ano yung value ng L in terms of H? So that's 2 times uppercase H times tangent theta over 2 times uppercase H raised to 3 halves. So pwede natin multiply yung constant na 2 sa 4 over 15. And multiply lang natin yung uppercase H to uppercase H raised to 3 halves. Since pares naman yung expression, kaya lang magkaiba yung exponent. So gagawin natin, since multiplication, i-add natin yung mga exponent. So that's 1 plus 3 halves. So yung magiging resulting equation na would be Q sub T is equal to 8 over 15 times the square root of 2G times tangent theta over 2 times uppercase H raised to 5 halves. So ito na yung magiging final na formula natin for theoretical discharge or theoretical flow rate. So take note lang ha, na yung theta is the vertex angle of the weir. So since yung na-derive natin is the theoretical discharge or theoretical flow rate, eh pwede na nating ma-derive din yung actual flow rate. So actual flow rate o yung actual discharge is Q sub A is equal to the coefficient of discharge C times the theoretical discharge Q sub T. So para dito sa triangular weir, so yung magiging Q sub A or yung actual discharge would be Q sub A is equal to 8 over 15 times C o yung coefficient of discharge times square root of 2G times tangent theta over 2 times uppercase H raised to 5 halves. So base dun sa formula, eh may makoconsider pa rin tayo dito na weir coefficient tulad dun sa rectangular weir. So para dito sa triangular, yung C sub W o yung weir coefficient is 8 over 15 times C times square root of 2G. So take note lang ha na iba yung C dun sa C sub W kasi yung C is the coefficient of discharge and yung C sub W is the weir coefficient. So upon substituting on the general equation for actual discharge, pag binalta natin yung 8 over 15 times C times square root of 2G into C sub W, the equation would become Q sub A is equal to C sub W times tangent theta over 2 times uppercase H raised to 5 halves. So gaya dun sa standard weir formulas natin, dun sa rectangular weir, meron din tayong kinoconsider na standard formulas para sa triangular weir o sa V-notch weir. So kapag ang vertex angle o yung theta is 90 degrees, yung formula for actual discharge. So, take note ha, actual discharge to, hindi theoretical discharge. So, that's 1.4 times uppercase H raised to 5 halves. So, ito ay para sa SI units. Para naman sa English units, that is Q sub A or Q or actual discharge is equal to 2.5 times uppercase H raised to 5 halves. So, automatic naman no, na para sa SI units, yung magiging final answer natin would be in terms of cubic meters per second kung ang gagamitin nating H is in terms of meters. Kapag ka naman sa English units, automatic na ang answer natin would be in cubic feet per second kung ang gagamitin nating H is in terms of feet. Ang sunod naman ay dun sa trapezoidal weir. So, yung trapezoidal weir, pwede natin gawin yung combination dun sa rectangular part ng trapezoidal weir at dun sa triangular part ng trapezoidal weir. So, pwede natin sabihin that the flow rate or the actual discharge of a trapezoidal weir is equal to the flow rate or the actual flow rate for the rectangular part plus the flow rate or the actual discharge at the triangular part. So, ganun lang kasimple yun. So, paghihiwalay natin yung calculation para dun sa rectangular part at dun sa triangular part ng trapezoidal weir. Para sa last part ng video na to, meron tayong tinatawag na Cipolletti weir. So, pag sinabi nating Cipolletti weir, ito ay trapezoidal weir. Kaya lang, meron siyang sariling unique na specification. So, tulad ng yung side slope ng Cipolletti weir ay merong slope na 1:4. So, that's 1 horizontal and 4 vertical. So, kung ganito yung slope, yung kanyang angle in reference to x dun sa side slope is 75.96 degrees. So, yung formula para makompute yung actual discharge, so take note ulit, actual discharge, hindi theoretical discharge. So, that's Q or Q sub A or actual discharge is equal to 1.859 times L times uppercase H raised to 3 halves. So, take note lang na yung L dito is yung width ng bottom side nung Cipolletti weir. So, hindi ito yung upper part ha, kundi yung bottom part yung i-consider natin dito. So, para naman sa English units, so yung formula for Q sub A or Q or actual discharge is 3.37 times L times uppercase H raised to 3 halves. So, ulitin ko lang, nakapagka sa SI units, ang ating final answer dito ay cubic meters per second. At ang gagamitin nating unit for L and uppercase H is in meters. Kapag ka naman sa English units, so that's cubic feet per second, yung discharge o yung actual discharge, at yung L and uppercase H should be in terms of feet. So, yun lamang. Sana may natutunan kayo. That would be all. Thank you so much.